In this video, I'll introduce the double cut extension for SketchUp and show how to create a component that cuts through both sides of a wall. With SketchUp's native tools, when placing a cutting component onto a wall face, it will cut just that face. With double cut, the same component will cut through to the other side of the wall as well, regardless of the wall thickness. As long as certain requirements are met, any SketchUp component can cut through walls with double cut. These can be components created from scratch, and many 3D warehouse models will cut through automatically without any need for modification. And for warehouse models that don't automatically cut through walls, it's easy to make the necessary modifications so that they will cut through. Here is the double cut toolbar. If you don't see this toolbar after installing, open the Extension Manager and verify that double cut is enabled. If you need to display the toolbar manually, you can find it in the View Toolbars menu. As a basic example, I have a set of walls and a floor. I'll click the first icon on the double cut toolbar, which inserts a simple 1 meter square cutting component. The component aligns to any face it touches, and when placed, cuts through both sides of the wall. If I move the component, the cuts follow, and I can rotate it while the Move tool is active and still maintain the cuts. Scaling works as well. And if I delete the component, the wall heals. In addition to other properties, a cutting component must include a closed set of coplanar edges that determine the shape of the wall cuts. In this sample component, the cutting shape is these four edges. Ideally, the cutting edges should be selectable when the component is open for editing. In addition, the plane of these closed edges must match the red-green plane of the component. I'll close the component, right-click on it, and choose Change Axes to see where the axes are now. The origin is at the corner of the cutting edges, and the red-green plane is along the cutting face. While the component is open, I can make some changes. I'll trace one of the cutting edges to add a face, which I'll make translucent. If I were to make this face and its edges into a group, the cutting edges would no longer be selectable, so I'll leave the face ungrouped. I'll also add a horizontal mutton. When I close the component, it still cuts through. Copies will cut as well, and I can bring in more from the in-model component collection. Now I'll show how to create from scratch a component that will work with double cut. In this example, the structure consists of several groups: two walls with non-parallel front and back faces, one floor, and a roof. A cutting component must be inserted directly onto a face, so I need to open one of the wall groups for editing. The cut direction will be perpendicular to the face where the component is placed. If I insert the component onto the sloped face, the cut direction will be slightly off from horizontal, so I'll place it on the vertical face instead. Any closed shape can be used for cutting, an arch in this example, which I'll draw directly on the face I'll be cutting. I'll select and double-click this face so that its edges will be included, and I'll make it a component. The default settings are correct. It will glue to any face, the red-green plane coincides with where the cut should be, and it's set to cut openings. When I create the component, the back face of the wall is cut, with a slightly larger cut width at the bottom than at the top. The front face appears uncut because the face itself is still part of the component. So I'll open the component for editing, and I could erase this face or paint it translucent. I can also offset to make a frame. The cutting edges are the outline of the translucent face, and as long as these remain selectable, the cutting will still work. I'll make a few copies along this wall and center them all. I want the same windows in the other wall, and I could open that group and insert three more. But let's say I want the existing windows copied into the same relative locations. I'll go back and select the windows in this group, plus the lower edge of the wall for reference, and copy them. Then I'll open the other wall group and paste them into blank space so that they can be rotated. The error message pops up because these three windows aren't glued to a face that they can cut. I'll rotate these 180 degrees and move them into place. Even though the windows are now along the face, they still don't cut because they're not yet glued to the face. So I'll add the face to what's already selected, click the glue icon, and now they cut through. In this example, some double cutting skylights have been added to the roof. Now say that there will be changes to this structure, and I want to keep the windows in place but disable the cuts for some of them. I'll go back inside one of the wall groups and select this window, then click the Disable icon. The choices here are to disable just the selected window, or all those in context, meaning all in the currently open wall group, or all in model. Disabling all in context, or all in model, will remove cuts from all affected components, including those that aren't identical to the selected component. Now the structure has been shortened, and I want to enable cuts on the components that are still entirely within their faces. I'll start with this wall group, select one of the windows, and click Enable. I can't enable cuts in the entire model, but I'll choose In Context, which works only on the relevant windows. This one I can delete. And I'll repeat for the other two groups. In the next video, I'll demonstrate how to modify 3D warehouse components so that they will work with double cut.